Hello everyone, this is Jordan and we're going to cover the opportunities we have currently based on the scanner, of course. Basically, let's see which opportunities are worth following at the moment. And if anything, of course, we're going to put updates in the Telegram group. So let's begin. First of all, pound dollar, as we can see, bullish. Well, the first thing we need to mention about the pounds is, of course, the Brexit, the deals, the negotiations, the uncertainty. So if you're going to trade the pounds at all, please do it very carefully, do it in the short term, and of course follow up on the news, when there will be votes and all that. Anything that could affect your trade, keep in mind of it, right? Excuse me. So that being said, let's check out the first opportunity. This is daily plus 1 hour combo. We have bullish sentiment, bullish momentum, and that's exactly what we're getting now. Using here the new checklist we've created, let's see a few examples of how to actually use it for those who still need to put it on the site, all these check marks and the output. Okay, I promise you guys, once you do it a few times, at the end you'll stop using this checklist indicator. You'll just be able to do it straight ahead and you'll not need any paper or this indicator or whatever. It will be just a matter of seconds, but it's a very good feature that will help you start with in the beginning once you're doing your analysis. So daily chart, we know it's bullish, that's perfect, this is the pattern. Now when we look at it, we can immediately see, and in this case even the indicator is catching the two divergences, we have bearish pressure, and this bullish delta pattern is coming after two divergences and two false breaks here, which means the pressure is currently bearish. On the other hand, we do have hidden divergence, but that hidden divergence almost crossed and created convergence to the downside. Okay, which means this situation is actually tricky. So technically speaking, we can go ahead and say that the higher time frame divergence is now gone. Okay, we don't have it now. Why? Because the higher time frame hidden divergence is now present. Whether this higher time frame divergence is present or not is one thing, and whether it is usable and tradable is another thing. Alright, so the easiest way to check if it's usable and tradable is to measure the last leg and see whether 61.8 was broken or not. 61.8 was broken even on that candle. So this part we can't really use. What we can be using here is, in my opinion, some kind of range, possible range to be formed, and of course that all makes sense given the fundamental sentiment that we're getting at the moment, right? Uncertainty. So being stuck in a range makes all the sense in the world. That means if we drop to the lower time frames, we can then be trading the possibility of this range. Okay, if anything presents itself as an opportunity. Then, moving on, dollar yen is a pair which I prefer at the moment to be trading on the lower time frames. And when I say lower time frames, let's just remind quickly what we have here in the scanner. This part, 4 hour chart in combo with the intraday time frames, is basically short term intraday opportunities, guys. Okay, then we have daily plus 1 hour and 4 hour. This is mid to long term trading, and then we have weekly and monthly plus their lower time frames, which is more or less long term and investment trading. Okay, usually I'm not covering these two simply because majority of the people, retail traders, are sticking to these combinations, but we have it available in the scanner because there are, after all, traders who do trade the higher time frames, and that's why we have it as an option. So going to Dorian, 4-hour chart and daily charts, everything is pointing bearish. Only monthly chart is currently pointing bullish. So starting from the 4-hour chart, let's see what we have. Going here to H4, we can see that the pattern looks good. Okay, let's go ahead and add here the indicator. And we can see that after this divergence was created, so once you get the divergence in the pattern, you're going to have this, right? You have hard time frame divergence against right here when the delta pattern is completed, which means you must wait, by all means you must wait until we get hidden divergence, which means this thing to form. Once that forms, you can then go ahead and say, okay, hard time frame divergence is cleared. Now we can say hard time frame hidden divergence is present, all right, which happened right here. And then we need to check for levels. Did we have levels? Yes, we did. So boom, we put levels here, and then as you can see, we got the move, and that was actually a very good trade, which managed to reach, I believe, target one only. Now, same situation repeats itself. However, this time on the hard time frames, we have a double wave. This double wave looks perfect as we're currently testing the 100%, but we should also go ahead and see whether we're keeping below 61.8 in order to assess this pullback, if it's too deep or not. And currently we can say it's perfect because it's keeping and holding below the 61.8 right here. So we do have the hidden time, the hidden divergence on the higher time frame, which started developing as a continuing divergence. This is a pretty classical situation. We have a magnet zone between the 100 and the 61.8, which is being tested by the pip right here, that zone. And the next thing we need to check is whether we have a level or not. So let's see the current situation. Do we have a level based on this high, and the lows here together with this low? We can say yes, we do have a level as well, which means I'm going to check that box again for the current situation. And now what does the indicator tells me? This is a conservative setup because we have the higher time frame divergence already in our direction, in the delta pattern direction. We do have a good level, okay, around and near the current price, and we can now be looking for entries, right? So now what you do is drop the 15 minute chart or the 30 minute chart, and you start looking for possible entries here to be delivered, and then we're looking for the sells. If the price creates something like that, that would be ideal, because then the risk reward ratio would be simply fantastic. Of course, looking at the bottom, we have all that place and room for bearish moves to be developed. Alright, so Dorian remains bearish, okay, and we can continue trading it. Right here, by the way, that was the last week move which managed to deliver some good setups. Daily chart, I'm not very interested in, simply because this kind of price action I really don't like. It's not very readable, especially with the huge spike that we had here. And furthermore, if that would be the delta pattern and the cycle, 61.8 broken. Even if we measure it to the whole leg, 61.8 again broke. Alright, so that plus not very clear price action on the higher time frames means I'm not very interested in this combination and the possible setups that could be provided here. Then we go to dollar franc, which by the way already has a sell setup here on the 4-hour chart. Higher time frame weekly is suggesting bullish, which is perfectly fine, because on the lower time frames we can easily get in and get out, and this one could be still valid. Okay, different time frames provide different cycles and moves which we can be enjoying independently from each other. So let's go ahead and see first of all, the 4-hour chart. Let me just remove the lines for a second. What do we have here, guys? Let's see. Let me again put the indicator on the chart. We have a nice delta pattern, okay? And we can say that there was no divergence here at the bottom right. Do we have, from the very first one even, high compared to the new highs now being created, do we have hidden divergence? Yes, we do. Immediately on this bounce, we managed to get the higher time frame divergence, which is again pushing now as continuing divergence. Is the price further away from 61.8? Yes, it is. Do we have parity level, which is psychological huge resistance zone for us? Yes, we do. It's right here. We're still below it. Do we have another level which is slightly closer to the current price? In my opinion, yes, we do. Why? Because of that zone right here. And that means I can go ahead and create something like that. And we see that the price is currently inside of this zone. Okay, so I can check that box as well, which means conservative setup is now in play. However, if we go ahead and drop to the 30-minute chart where the setup was, we can see that the price is currently ranging and trading inside this ugly zone here. This divergence is definitely not what we're looking for. In order for a divergence to be valid and tradable, most of all, we need to see some kind of clear waves moving, okay? We need to see this or that. When this is what we get, and around these highs, let's say, or around these lows, we get divergences, that's not the best scenario for us. It simply isn't. Okay? So, based on that alone, I wouldn't go ahead and trade this setup. However, I would trade it, and I believe it is tradable, because we have a fantastic level already. Okay? Because this pullback or correction has been developing for some time now, and the MACD is pretty close to the zero, which means the momentum, if we consider this as a short-term bullish momentum, right, the corrective cycle, the momentum is supposed to turn down. Having the risk reward on our side, that means when we put all the whole analysis together, we can be trading that with tiny exposure, okay, as a pure risk reward trade. What does that mean? It means that we have that zone. I know this is the top of the zone, and I know the price, if it breaks higher, we're probably going to see further moves up, which means I can protect here or slightly higher around the 38.2 if I want to be conservative. We also see that the range is wide, which means we need to set a pending order, and this is exactly what I'm going to do. Okay, so the stop loss, that would be the more aggressive one, and that would be the more conservative one. So for this specific trade, let's go ahead and choose the conservative one. Okay, just giving it a few more pips here from the highs, in case we get a spike or something to be covered. Okay, then target one, I'm going to adjust usually like this, so you get one to one, right? But in that case, as we move the stop loss higher, I need to push the target lower. So if this is around 20 pips, I need to get at least 20 pips as well. 20 pips, however, is pretty close here, okay? So let's find the next zone towards the bottom. And the next zone, in my opinion, is somewhere around here. You see all this, that small zone where the price stopped for some reason? This is where I want to be collecting my target. So let's go ahead and put target one approximately there, which is then going to give me, what's that, 22 versus 31, right? And inside the risk reward ratio towards target one, you can see 1.3, which is slightly above 1, but it's still above 1. Alright, now target 2, I'm going to adjust towards the bottom, just a few pips above it, like this, which is going to give me approximately 2.6 in terms of risk reward. Okay, so that's about it. I'm now going to place my order, and now all we need to do is wait. Okay, then that's about dollar franc. Let's just quickly refresh it. All right, then we have Kiwi, which is only hard time frame place, and weekly plus daily actually managed to pay this setup already. That setup was based on this move here. Okay, now the problem with that is we might be getting a double wave here. Okay, this is what we currently have, and 61.8, yes, it was reached, but 100 in order to get something like that is very, very possible to be achieved. So that's about weekly chart. Now going back to daily chart, if you remember this setup, we've been discussing it for some time. Look what we have. The hard time frame range is wide, which means once you put your pending order, it goes automatically to the 50%. That means when you put the target one towards the bottom here of that range, right, and you get the trigger, stop loss, target one immediately reached. And this is exactly and precisely why the pending orders were created this way, to put the entry here in the middle, because during the research and the analysis that were done before we released the software, we saw that if the higher time frame range is too wide and we get the pullbacks very deep, we're going to probably get into a range afterwards. And if we do get into a range, we want this trade to be profitable, and then if it continues lower, perfect, we get target 2. If it's stuck in a range, you actually make money, right? Regardless of what happens afterwards. Because imagine the situation, you sold here with this protection, then your target is not reached. And then even if it's reached, as we have here in daily chart, you need to wait for months before this target will be actually reached by the price. Which means if the swap is against you, you need to pay unnecessary fees, and you have open exposure for too long time. Of course, if that's the 15 minute chart, it will take a few days to develop, which is not that bad. But when it comes to the higher time frames, the idea is to get out immediately and collect some profits in case there will be a range afterwards. And once again, the statistics prove themselves. Okay, higher time frame wide, the range is wide, get the order from above inside this range here, get out at the bottom, clean trade. Okay, clean execution. That's about QE. Now the lower time frames, we said, are actually bullish. Okay, and this is what we're referring to. The daily chart did push to the upside, and this is something again which I don't really like, simply because we have the two time frames here. It's time to get the tick, please. The two time frames are pointing against each other, and it's really inside the range, which means we can go either way at that stage. So this one, not really what I'm looking for, and not really tradable in my opinion. At least I'm staying away until something better appears on the chart. Then pound franc, looking for the sells. Let's see, this is 4-hour chart, short-term trading, and so on and so on. The last delta pattern was right here. We got the push, we got the move down. Now we're back at the bottom, And there is a very good chance, if I zoom out, you will see that there is a very good chance we will be stuck in a range. Okay? These levels are respected. That level right here, together with this double bottom, are respected. Furthermore, we do have now divergence. Okay? So, what do we do in that case? Let's bring up the indicator. And if I have divergence against me, I'm going to say hard time frame divergence is against. And that means not tradable. No further analysis needed. Nothing else. As long as you have divergence on the higher time frame where the delta pattern is, it's simply not tradable, guys. We need to have opposite divergence, which is the hidden divergence appearing, that is going to kill this one and invalidate it. And only then we can start looking for the possible sell opportunities. Okay? This one we can immediately close here. Pound yen daily suggesting bullish, weekly suggesting bearish. Pretty similar situation as with the kiwi. So let's go ahead and see what do we have. First of all, let's check out the weekly chart, removing that. And we said we have bearish pushing downwards. Okay, that would make sense, but the current scenario which is developing here, not very clear if you ask me. We first of all trying to break above this channel, right? This is the one. And the price is spiking up and down of this trend line. So price action alone is absolutely uncertain of what we are going to get here. Okay? And that's the whole reason why this setup on weekly, alright, doesn't currently, well, it's not something I'm very eager to trade. And after all, this is the pound, so again, very likely we're waiting for the fundamentals to give us the next direction, okay, on the higher time frames. Then we have on the daily chart, what was the direction? On daily chart, pound yen is bullish. So let's see, pound yen bullish, divergence against, and double bottom. So this hidden divergence is now turning into a possible convergence here. Okay, so again, the idea of possible range, all right, or false break and push up gets in place. That means I would be agreeing with the bullish possible scenario to be forming at that moment. And that means we need to go to the lower time frames and look for extra confirmations of whether this is going to be happening or not. 4-hour chart, divergence, check. False breaks for possible range, check. Do we have a trend line breakout yet? No, we don't. Okay, and on the 1-hour chart, excuse me here. Now, this is the divergence we want to see on the 1-hour chart, and we do have it. Actually, that was the very first divergence right here. If you can see it, whether it's one leg divergence or we had the actual tick here, doesn't really matter. That was the first attempt for the price to continue higher. And that attempt is usually tradable because we're pretty close to the bottom. However, it is aggressive because we didn't actually touch the bottom. Now we did, okay? And now we have 2 consecutive false breaks. Along with PMP divergence, sorry, NPN divergence. That means break above this high would mean we're back in the bullish game conservatively. Okay? If you want to be aggressive and already traded, pullbacks and buys, okay, inside this leg. Pullbacks and buys. If you want to be more conservative, break above, pullbacks and buys. So pound yen looks good in my opinion for the short term, mid short term, to look for the buys on the lower time frames. All these I'm skipping because they're the higher time frames. Moving forward to Eurocad, which says daily is currently bullish. Okay, and this is what we have. Do we have anything currently on the 1 hour chart which suggests we're to the close? To the end of this bearish momentum, the current possible corrective cycle? No. It actually says we have one more leg probably coming downwards. Why? Because we have a fantastic move to the downside. We have price action suggesting that we're going to continue lower. So on the 1 hour chart, there is still nothing to be done. On the daily chart, however, we need to assess the situation. And the situation is, if that would be our delta pattern, okay, this is what we're looking for, right? First of all, we have the bigger range right here, and then move up, push to the downside. Now we're expecting, based on this delta pattern, continuation upwards. However, the price, as we said, never managed to reach here, right? The bottom of this big range, which is tricky. That means this is a very possible scenario, which means this leg might not be as corrective as we can expect. Furthermore, that was the initial move, that was the initial correction, and we got the push up. So very likely, whether we traded or not, this setup, the move was already provided here. Okay, now on a second phase, when we start trading the further pullbacks towards the top before invalidation, it becomes more aggressive. Why? Because the very first one was already delivered. This is the initial move after the corrective wave that we're looking for. Any further setup that we might be provided during pullbacks later on becomes automatically more aggressive. Okay, so that's pretty much my idea here. And of course, the deal breaker, which we probably should have started with, is 61.8 broken. If the correction is too deep, that setup and the buys here are very aggressive, or we should be skipping them. Usually when that happens, I'm trying to find extra confirmations using other knowledge, not just the delta pattern idea on its own, to confirm whether to have an entry or not. Okay? And in that case, we did have these extra confirmations. We were looking at a channel here. For those of you who are in the club, you probably remember. And we were looking for breakouts on the lower time frames that can provide us with this actual move to the upside. Excuse me. So that's about Eurocad. In my opinion, the last delta pattern is bullish, but we need to be careful there and only wait until the 1 hour chart cycle completes itself. And once that happens, as we said right here, we might be getting then an opportunity for that buy. Okay, so something like that, for example. But again, we need to be patient. So at that stage, we don't have much here. Euro Kiwi, totally bearish, okay, from all the time frames we do have. So let's start with the daily chart. Bearish, bearish, bearish. And this is the place where I'm not really agreeing with the software for one reason only. We have a very strong level which we have reached. Okay, and since we have reached that level, I would expect for the price to bounce. Furthermore, looking at that cycle to the downside, we can then agree with the software that we're supposed to see something like this, right? Continuation downwards. But before we can agree and start selling, in my opinion, we should be looking at some sort of pullbacks to the upside. Now, looking at the very, very, very actual delta setup here, of course, that was a bigger picture, but the setup which the software is referring to is this one. And compared to the previous moves, this is not really tempting and not something we can be, tempted to trade, right? So you can see how tiny the moves are. Obviously, we are inside the range here, and we need this range to be broken either up or down. Until then, this is not really a delta pattern I would be trading or referring to. Simply arranging, so nothing clear at that stage. Maybe on the lower time frames we can go ahead and trade something, but then again we have the level. You can see where the price bounced off of specifically, and if that would be the last delta pattern right here, we did get the hidden divergence, yes, but you can see that the price crossed 61.8 within a single candle. Okay, that means something, guys. So when you see such setups, skip it, right? Simply skip it. Then we have, what do we have? Let's check out the next chart. Pound cut, totally bullish, 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 bullish. Let's see what we have, 77.69. Down to 69. So this is the last delta pattern which the software is referring to, and this is where, again, based on price action, we said we're looking for possible bounces, and we did get the bounces off of that zone. Now this is the interesting part, because let's add here, the checklist. We get the delta pattern at the close of the first bearish bar here, right? First histogram, red histogram. So on this bar right here, once it closed, we had bullish delta pattern appearing and the software alerting us for it. However, we do have a divergence against right here, right? So what we're going to do is click higher time frame, the divergence is against us. And we see that we must wait for the hidden divergence on the higher time frame before any entries. That means we need to get hidden divergence right here. And that's perfectly fine, because we're pretty soon, probably today or tomorrow, going to get something that reminds hidden divergence. We're actually dealing with one at the moment with the current daily bar. But we do now have lower lows, and that means divergence plus convergence. Okay, so in other words, if that would be convergence, we can expect pullbacks to the upside, and we can go ahead and trade what is supposed to be here a corrective cycle, because afterwards we're probably going to see one more push lower, possibly to the bottom of that zone, and then either or. Okay, but you gotta put the whole picture together, okay, to see the complete puzzle and where the game is going and how it's going to form, all right, based on the statistics and the patterns we use. So yes, we do have the hidden divergence, let's say today or tomorrow. But keep in mind that the second target, for example, might not be reached, and you might want to cut the entire position, not just target one, once you reach a certain zone or level. Okay, because based on that, the expectation would be possible push to the downside. Okay, that's my view on pound cut here. Pound kiwi, franc yen, daily bullish. Now, Frank Yen, I'll go to weekly chart for a second just to show the bullish divergence, guys. Right? That puts bullish pressure and we have the trend lines here. Then, going down to the daily chart, we can see that the price action is currently stuck inside, well, nothing. Right? And this is where Frank Yen for me ends. That's all, as simple as that. Even if the software is referring to this delta pattern, this delta pattern is not a move that represents momentum. This is a move that represents momentum. Alright? This is a move that represents momentum. This is not. I mean, look at it. By all means, this is not what we're looking for. So, I would simply go ahead and ignore it. Then we have Aussie cat for buys, weekly for sales. So let's see the lower time frames, the 4-hour chart, looking at possible bullish momentum. Okay. And that would be the zone where the delta pattern formed, right? This is where I'm going to place here. That's the big one. Let's see what the levels are giving us. This is okay. And then on the very last leg, so leg number one, and that would be leg number two, I'm going to place this one here, which means 61.8 either or is below. So based on that, the setup is more or less still tradable. We do have a trend line. Just draw it for a second very quickly. We do have a trend line which is showing here that the price is currently holding above it. Okay, ABCD pattern which did form together with hidden divergence which started forming as continuing divergence, and on Friday we said this is where we are looking to actually go ahead and buy. We were first of all looking for the sales right here in order to trade the ABCD, that paid off, and then switching immediately for the buy setups. Okay, unfortunately, no buys were provided right here, at least not according to the software. Only advanced trading of some sort, which could be step trading or trend lines or anything else you might have for the actual entry, right? But the delta pattern here managed to deliver overall in terms of directions. Now, if you're still in a buy, mind the divergence against you. If you'd like to be trailing stops, that would be the place, in my opinion, where the trailed stop should be coming to. All right. So Aussie cat looking good, I remain bullish, and this is a place where we might be looking for further entries as the price is developing. Aussie yen, bearish, bearish, bearish. So let's see what do we have. We have a range. Alright. Daily chart, we have a range. So any pattern that you might be having on the daily chart, right, in my opinion, not relevant. 4-hour chart, same story, we have a range. Any pattern that we might be having inside of it, not very relevant. The only thing I would be doing for this pair is trading the range, nothing more than that. Pretty much same story applies to Aussie dollar, Aussie franc, okay, majority of them. CAD yen also suggesting bearish all over the place. Let's go ahead and see the bigger picture. If that would be the bearish pattern, 61.8 in that case is more or less acceptable. Price action not very clear, that move here not very clear. But what would be clear for me now is this ABCD and the price pushing upwards. What is also clear in this case is that the initial pullback is now finished. So that's the entry right here that we're looking for. Initial move to the downside, pullback, maybe even one more push downside, I don't care, no problem. But the initial move and pullback is now finished, guys. So any pullback now that we might be trading is more aggressive. Okay? And very quickly reminding you, Cadian weekly chart has bullish divergence against, and there is no hidden divergence invalidating the current bullish pressure. So keep that in mind when it comes to Cadian and, well, basically all of the EM pairs, which are showing the same thing on weekly. CAD franc, same story. Everything is pointing to the downside. Every single delta pattern. So let's go ahead and check out the higher time frames. Weekly chart, not very attractive, even though that this is weekly chart, which means we have plenty of room here to trade intraday opportunities. But referring to the range theory, last time we reached the range, top or bottom, okay, last time was the bottom. That means we're looking at the top as the next destination, okay, possibly, which doesn't really fit and meet what we're looking for in terms of sales. The trend line, this trend line right here on the other hand, does meet the bearish requirements, which means the closer we get to this trend line, that would be a nice place to start looking for the sales. What we can do also here is get levels. This is one such level, and that also is one such level. Alright? Now let's drop to the lower time frames and check out the delta patterns. Since this is a range, not very valid, okay? But the range is too wide, which means in this case it is acceptable for us to look at the direction. Okay, but still, as a rule of the thumb, remember that when you have a range and a delta pattern inside of it, reliability drops significantly. Now that's the last push down, that's what would appear to be a corrective cycle. And this is immediately where the whole idea would be more or less invalidated or become super aggressive, as 61.8 is broken. So even if you don't get the part about the ranges and you don't know how to identify them, having the 61.8 broken is going to suggest that something is already wrong and you should be very careful trading this situation. In my opinion, CAD franc, the only thing to do here is drop to the lower time frames and do advanced trading. This line is too long. All right, do advanced trading on the lower time frames, scalping. That's all. Now this pattern on the 4 hour chart starts to look much, much better, guys. All right, we had the first wave, continuation lower. Now there is no divergence against. There is hidden divergence forming right here. We have a beautiful zone. That means any pullback and continuation lower is fantastic for the sales. Basically, the closer we get to that zone right here, the better. Okay, we can be looking for these sell opportunities. Or did I click here? Hold on 1 second, let's refresh it quicker. CAD franc, CAD yen, Kiwi franc, Kiwi CAD. Bullish versus bearish. And that's the part where we need to think twice what's happening and why is it happening. Okay, daily chart. Bullish delta pattern. This is the pattern we are looking for right here. Right? It suggests bullish continuation. And that would make sense because we have a triple cycle, we had the correction, we had a range, and now looking at possible continuation to the upside. It also makes sense because when we go ahead and measure that entire move here, we will see that 61.8 is closer to the previous high, and that would be our at least ABCD pattern that we can expect to to see. On the other hand, there was a divergence completing itself right here. Okay? And that divergence, together with the level that we have around the top, the resistance, is pushing the price very seriously to the downside. We are now bouncing and reaching a very strong zone and level, which is the top of the previous range, but that push to the downside looks very, very strong and powerful, which means we need to wait. Well, this is what actually the software does for us, but overall, even if you're not trading it with the software, we need to wait for the conservative entries, at least in my opinion, before we can start looking at possible buys. On the 4-hour chart, there is a trend line, a bit lower. It would be nice for us to see some kind of ABCD pattern like that to form before we can actually step in and look for the buy trades, okay? And if I do the Fibos, you'll see that 61.8, well, given that we have some angle, right, is going approximately towards that zone. Now I would like to mark a few levels, so starting from the very, very bottom, that would be the place. Then we have one more here, and then we have this tiny zone right here. Okay, so if anything, we can go ahead and split these two levels like that, here and here. Now let's remove those so we clean up the chart a bit. And this is how it would look like, approximately. Okay? So, let's see if the price can deliver this move. If it does, on the 1-hour chart, we would be looking at this possible move. You can see that there is already divergence, which the software managed to catch here. And break above would give us two arrows on the scanner and possible bullish continuation. But again, for me, that would not be entirely, well, not the most conservative idea, right? As we said, we are near the bottom of the previous range. So it makes sense for first attack. Absolutely makes sense. It's tradable. But the more conservative idea would be to have the price near a better level, double confirmed or triple confirmed, and then look for the attacks. But again, that's up to you to decide which way you would like to go ahead and trade it. All right, that's about KiwiCat. And then the last one is gold, which on weekly chart is suggesting that we're going downwards. Right, this is the weekly pattern, which is a bit tricky because the only low that we had was this one. I mean, lower lows here, right? So that was convergence, divergence, classical pullback looking for continuation, but the pullback here was too deep. Right, we managed to cross above 61.8. And that means, again, we might be going for the actual top here. Alright, and this is the tricky part. So, only conservative entries. The first conservative entry we had was right here. The breakout 50% or slightly below reached. Of course, the 50% is approximate. Every time you put the set pending, you click the set pending button and you start dealing with pending orders, it's better to find yourself a good level. And for me, a good level would be starting for this place and then, let's say, that place or slightly lower right here to cover more points. Okay, that's from the back. And on that side, when we look for entries, that would be this zone because of these spikes here. And then slightly higher, that zone, because of that close and these candles right here. Usually, the best would be to look for at least the price to reach approximately 50%. Well, that's a bit messy now. But there you go, this is the 50%. So yes, it did miss just a few points, but I think you got the idea. Usually what I would do is exactly like that, go ahead and check out the levels, where the levels are, and just place the order few points or pips below the actual level. So if that would be my level right here, okay, based on these candles and those candles, I'll be placing my order right here. So yes, you're not catching the absolute top of the move, but you're also missing if you don't catch it, right? So not being greedy for a few pips, it's perfectly fine. Anyway, so that was the idea here of the pullback and then continuation to the downside. This trade is almost reaching the target. Well, of course, that depends on where your target would be. This is a good level to start cashing out, and of course you can be looking at the lower time frames for possible divergences to form against you. In my opinion, we're going to see further moves down towards here. On the 4-hour chart, things also look good. I like it. This is the most recent bearish delta pattern, which also managed to provide here the breakouts. We were talking about this one, and in that case, in my opinion, we should be looking, even if that was okay and not white, we should be looking for pullback, simply because that move here, guys, that entire range is too big. All right, so again, I'd rather miss than be exposed to such kind of situations. So I believe that's pretty much everything, at least on my chart. If you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to post your comments below for any pair which I might not covered, or commodity or stock, whatever you have in mind. If it was not covered, please post it below and I'll give you my input. Or of course you can do that in the Telegram groups. So thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like it, thumbs up, share it, and have a wonderful week.